Create with Franz Sydney. Hello everyone, welcome to the show. I hope you're having a wonderful week. It just started, you know, it's a Monday when my show is published, and so I'm hoping you're getting a really, really good beginning of the week. Today I wanted to talk about something that is not really a mental health problem. Sometimes we don't really need therapy because we have anxiety or depression, but simply because we are looping our thoughts or maybe our habits, and we are therefore creating results that we don't want without realizing that it's just a habit. And some of our habits might be really, really good, while others can actually take us to a place we do not like to be. Stephen Covey, the author of Seven Habits of the Most Successful People, he said that all things are created twice, first mentally and then physically. And the key to creativity is to begin with the end in mind, with a vision and a blueprint of a desired result. Now, looking back in my life, how many times did I do that? Zero times. For many years, I didn't think about the end in mind. You know, I just went and did something. And instead, I should have done that. And now that I'm a coach, actually I'm an NLP coach and a hypnotherapist, I understand a lot better that unless we have a very clear understanding of our destination, we cannot get there. And so we need to know where we're going so that we can understand where we are and what are the steps that are missing to go into the right direction. So this is because we are not the product of what's going on around us, or the circumstances that we have. We are the products of our own decisions. And sometimes without really thinking, we take small decisions every day, like getting out of bed or not, eating well or not, exercising or not, being kind to others or not. And all these small decisions, plural, make quite a big difference in how our day goes. So maybe we're not suffering from a very complex mental disorder. We are simply in the need of changing our habits, and that in turn will change our life. So if you think you need a change, but you don't think you have a mental health issue or problem, then keep tuning in, because you might find a few useful suggestions. First of all, just to make sure we all agree on what is a habit is simply what we always do to navigate every day and all the little things we have to do, from how we get out of bed, how we brush our teeth, how we drive. It's just something that makes it so much easier for us to live, because we become very efficient, because we do everything always in the same way and we can do it faster. And this is very ingrained in our brains as we grow up. We're very attached to the way we do things, and sometimes this can create more problems than it solves. But we are just so attached to how we do things, and especially after the age of 70, 80, it can be really difficult to have maybe a talk with our parents or grandparents and help them, because they don't want to change anything. They like things as they are, and they don't want anything different. But of course, that's part of aging. But if we have a problem earlier and the habit we have is not helping us, then it's time to sit back and say, well, what's going on here? What can I do? I'm going to give you another example. For example, every time we are stressed, we might be reaching for the cigarette, or we might get a drug, or we might decide, I'm going to go and run because I'm feeling stressed. As we do this over and over, we get into the habit of doing so. Every time we're stressed, we repeat that behavior. And then because we are repeating something, we are literally engraving a new path in our brain, and the synapses are created, and this becomes natural. Why? Because all humans are creatures of habit. We are absolutely lovers of not wasting our time, and we want to use the energy for things that are fun and interesting. We don't want to wake up every day and measure with a tape measure, well, how long do we have to walk to get to the kitchen? You know, how many steps? Shall I jump out of bed from the right or from the left? No, we just do it always in the same way, so that it's fast. And we do that through learning, through repetition, and by maybe while we're trying to get a goal, for example, you're trying to satisfy an appetite or something, we associate certain cues with our behavior response that will help to meet the goal. For example, we know how to turn at a certain street, or we know where to stop at our restaurant. We know, oh yeah, I'm hungry, I can stop there and get something. So it's all very useful for us, at least on the surface. So obviously, I don't want you to confuse between a routine and a habit. A routine is something that you have to do, like going to school every day or going to work every day, but it's not that you have an impulse to do it, you just have to get on with it, you know? Or you need to do the dishes, you just do the dishes. It's not that you really crave doing the dishes, you just have to get on and you're very good in discipline. While a routine is sometimes even enforced, a habit is something that we do not get enforced. We choose to do it and then it becomes so unconscious, we just get on. And sometimes we have bad habits. For example, we eat more than we should be eating, or maybe we are so attached to social media that we don't even look up anymore. We're just endlessly scrolling, or maybe television. Some people just have this remote control thing and they cannot put it down because they're used to jump from one channel to the other, and then they cannot sleep at all because they are all agitated. And it's really, really hard to break the habits. Isn't that amazing? So hard. It's just a simple thing, isn't it? Turn it off, put away the cigarette. It's so difficult. However, although it is so difficult to stop doing something that is not very conducive to good health, emotional health, or physical health, it is important to know that it is also possible to create a new good habit that we like to have and that gives us results that we actually appreciate. If you just use the same context, the same dynamics that you had in the past to build the habit that you do not like anymore, you can then create a new habit. So you want to think about the situation that you want to create and the behavior that you want to have to be in a certain mental state, and then you want to repeat a good behavior that you have chosen, and you want to attach a little reward to the behavior, like a good experience, for example. And I don't know, for example, let's say that you want to exercise every day and you stopped when the lockdown started. Okay, so if you have stopped exercising, what good reward could you use? Could you use, for example, listening to music when you're doing exercise? Or could you spend some time with a friend when you exercise, maybe go running together? So that's something good, is a good experience, and it's not a food reward, which of course would lead you to another problem later on. So you can build that habit with little incentives, a little internal force that is pushing you to do this good action, it's so good for you. And anything can do, as long as you appreciate doing it, and treat yourself, you're going to watch a movie, or you're going to spend time with your loved ones more. Whatever you want that is good for you, you can use it as a good incentive. My tip would be, when you change your habit, whatever that is, if it's not smoking anymore or not using bad words anymore, you want to be really careful at the words that you're telling yourself about those new habits. So instead of saying, oh no, I should really be doing this or doing that, you say, I choose, I like, I enjoy. So when you're feeling stressed and you're going to reach for the drug or cigarette or whatever, you don't say, oh no, I cannot have a cigarette, I promised myself I would never do that. No, you do, I could have a cigarette, but I choose to have a walk outside because it makes me feel great. So the way you repeat that, it really helps you to build the habit with a positive inclination, instead of thinking that this is a weight on you, is something very, very hard. Even if it's hard, if you choose positive words, that helps you so much. And this is simply because your mind will create an image of whatever words you are using. So if you create a happy image of yourself using this new habit to create a good result in the end, You will visualize that there will be an electrical impulse sent in your brain from one neuron to the other, and that will be reinforced as you keep saying to yourself, yeah, I'm good, I can do this, I choose to do this. So remember, the power of your word is very, very good. And tip number two, do not give up straight away if your habit is becoming a little bit difficult after 3 or 4 days. Let's say that the majority of people said it takes at least 10 days to start a good habit. But in many cases, it can take many, many months to really solidify a habit. For example, I never really used to do exercise every day. So I signed up and went to the gym 2 or 3 times a week for 4 years. After that, I stopped, there was the lockdown anyway, and I realized that it was very easy because after 4 years, I knew all the exercises and I had enough space in my bedroom and I just got on with it. And now I still exercise every day because I got used to it. But first, I had to go to the gym and I had to pay and I had to suffer, lose my money to do that, to get into the habit. So give yourself time to build this habit, to do something new, something difficult, something different, until it becomes second nature. So now, if I don't exercise, I can tell the difference and I miss it and I stop what I'm doing, if possible, and then I do a little bit of flexibility and jumping around to get back to that state of wellness. And the same can be done for everything else, but it does take a few months. So for this reason today, I have posted something on Facebook that was a little bit fun for me. I don't know if you've seen it. Basically, we have a very, very cheap wildlife camera, and sometimes I put outside some food in the hope to see some of the hedgehogs we have in our garden, or maybe some squirrels or blackbirds. And this week, I put a few peanuts still in the shell, and because I know that some of the animals are looking for hibernations and they're looking for food, we have quite a few squirrels. And then when I retrieved the photographs, I thought, oh, this is so good, because there was really the sequence of 5 actions that the squirrel did when he saw the nuts. First, you see this ecstatic expression on his face when he realizes there are like 10 nuts on the floor. He's like, wow, was that I wanted? Then you see that he started to put his body in the correct direction, and then he's launching himself, picks up some of the nuts, eats one, and then disappears. And you have this wonderful quick photo of his really, really large tail that is all open up. It looks like he's a ghostly thing. It's really fun. But see, he just didn't do all the overthinking that we did. He just looked around. There's nobody there. I'm safe. I'm going to jump in the middle of nowhere, get the nuts, I'm focused on this. And then he went off. While we as human beings might see something very good that we want to have, not just a peanut, but maybe something a lot better, maybe a goal of health or emotional happiness, whatever that is. Maybe having a degree, getting a new job, finding a boyfriend, it doesn't matter, it's a goal. We see the goal in our mind, we visualize it, oh, this is so good, I would love to have that. But then, before we start taking action, we start talking to ourselves in a very critical way that we would not use with anyone else. And we start saying, well, you're not good enough for this, he's not going to like you, or the guy is not going to hire you, or you're not going to lose the weight, you're just going to fail again. So we don't even try. We just skip first, the second, the third, and the fourth step that the squirrel has done, and we go straight to the end, and we just run off, because we are terrified that we will not be able to reach the goal. But the only thing that you can do when you have a goal is to not just dream about it, but to have steps. And the steps, many, many times, are to actually build a healthy habit. And this takes consistency. And we know that it's very, very hard, but it has to be done. Or should I say, but I want this to happen, right? Because when we have an old habit that has been there for 10 years, 20 years, we are just running on autopilot. And when we're doing something like that, something that we do always wrong, but we don't care, is because the brain is not using any judgment on that. It just, we're just doing it. That's how we just, you know, we've always done it there, like biting the nails or whatever. They're so ingrained. And they still give us this little rewarding feeling from the beginning. Or sometimes they don't even do that. We're just doing it and we actually hate our habit. Which one is your situation? I don't know, but whatever that is, it's too ingrained to come out. And that's why we think it's going to be impossible. But you know what? It's just in our thoughts. It's a thought. It's not there. So why do we find it impossible to even think about it? So my suggestion, that's tip number 3, is to think of why we have the bad habits to begin with. And then list on a piece of paper what kind of options, maybe 2-3 options, do we have so that we can change that? Yeah? So after you think about that, you write down your list and then think about it. Why did I start with this bad habit? Can I remember that? Can I get out of that somehow? And then think, why would I want something different? What is coming in the end? What are the peanuts I'm going to find? You know, if I want to do like my little squirrels. So, of course, this will open up your mind regarding the problems that you're trying to soothe, maybe a state of emotional stress, or just you're trying to cut corners here and there. Whatever that is, just make sure it's not part of an addiction, in which case you do need a therapist or a mental health professional, so something to get you out of the addiction. But normally speaking, just look at why you want to change, what you want to change. Just detach yourself from your feelings and just sit down as if you are talking to another person and say, okay, if I want to achieve this, what do I need to do? Write it down. Then start to break it down in small bites or little bits maybe. So you want to start and begin with the end in mind. Think about how you want to feel in the end. Divide it. Say, well, I want this to happen within 3 months. Okay, so what has to happen between now and 3 months? So if I have, we're now in November, almost December. Okay, if I say, by the 1st of January, I want to have lost 10 kilos. That means, let's say 10 kilos is a little bit too much, let's say 3 kilograms. Well, that means that it's pretty much 1 kilo a week. Okay, so to lose 1 kilo a week, how many calories do I have to burn? How many foods do I have to change in my diet? How many minutes of exercise do I want to do? How many minutes of walking or mindfulness? What kind of different foods will I introduce instead? So work it out exactly how you're going to do it. Then pick up week 1, week 2, week 3, and week 4. Your goal has to be done by, let's say, January. And you write down every week in your planner what you're going to do, how you're going to do, when you're going to do it. Then you don't have just a wish, you have a goal. And then, because you know how you're going to do it, then you start doing it every day. You have a reminder, and that allows you to change your habit, because every time you automatically reach from the muffin or cupcake or whatever, you stop in the air, your hand is paralyzed, like, wait a minute, oh yeah, I got a plan here that I wanted to stop eating all of these cakes. I'm just choosing the cake thing because it's just easy to say. There are lots of habits, so don't worry about the food one. But you know, as we're heading towards Christmas, it could be a good idea to look at what we're eating and why we're eating it. Because sure enough, in January, we're going to be talking again about why the goals from last year has not worked. So just give yourself a benefit of doubt and give yourself a goal that you can reach with a good habit. And it will be a very, very good progression route for you, because you know what you're doing and why you are doing it. For example, I have a friend who every morning used to wake up and she and her husband would be laying in bed on the social media for an hour before even going to work. And then they realized that this was putting quite a distance between themselves and it was not looking very good. So they both decided, okay, in the morning, our devices are going to be shut down and we're going to be in another room by the front door. And so when they woke up, there was nothing there. And they used to spend the time to have a quick chat, maybe do exercise together, meditate together, or listen to good music and have breakfast together in the kitchen. And they really changed also the relationship. They had to change this habit because it maybe started once because it was an urgent message, and then slowly the mobile device ended up in the bedroom and it was taking so much of their time and energy. So they had to do the new habit. They talked together, they put it in practice. And you know, just in the same way, we can all do that. We can look at those habits that we have that are not good, they're not helping us, they're making us waste time or not feeling very good, and we can make this decision. And we can do this today. We can say, right, this podcast gave me an idea. What is it I would like to change? And then put it down. Just put it on this piece of paper. The fact it is there will help you to start coming up with great ideas. So good luck, and I hope you get great success with this. Let me know how it goes. So that was it for today. Thank you for listening, and I hope that in some way my episode was useful for you. So please feel free to share this episode with anyone that might enjoy it, and click like or even write a review, because they are so useful for us. So thank you again, and I'll see you next week. Bye-bye. You've listened to Create with Franz Sidney.